Alrighty, welcome to the first two-story props video tutorial on fiberglassing. Right now we're going to be working on doing a gel coat with some pore cast microbulb filler and fiberglass resin. As you can see, I've already poured out an amount of fiberglass resin. We're going to be casting up a Toma helmet ear from Daft Punk. This is the mold I've made. And to begin with the gel coat, you want the microbulb filler, which is these little microscopic glass beads. You want roughly the same amount of filler to resin. You don't want to go more filler to resin because it'll make the resin kind of chalky and difficult to pour and paint. So basically I have gone ahead and put in the filler to the resin, and I'm going to go ahead and stir it up before we add the fiberglass hardener, and that will allow the filler to be fully integrated into the liquid resin so that you're not having to stir and race against time, you know, to get everything mixed together. And here I'm adding the hardener, which for the amount that I tend to use in the resin, typically ends up being 30 drops of hardener. Now, it is a pretty warm day, and I excuse the buzzing sound you may hear in the background. That's the AC. I'm out here on my back porch. But it's a warm day, so I gotta kind of race against the clock, because the warm temperature will want to make the resin cure faster. And so I don't want to waste a lot of resin and have it cure up in the cup. Now this is a pretty simple piece, but to prevent any air bubbling, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pour it in a thin bead, just down into the center of the part. And I've done a couple of these, so I know not to use all of it. But to begin the process, I'm going to start slushing it around the part. I don't have to use the entire surface area of this part. I'm going to end up cutting most of it away. But what I'm going to do anyway is just to be sure I have enough fiberglass there on the finished part, is I'm going to go ahead and finish up the entire piece. I have some throwaway brushes here. This is a 2-inch brush. I got it in a pack of 36 from Harbor Freight. My local Home Depot doesn't carry throwaway brushes in bulk, so you have to buy their little $2 a brush nonsense. And what I'm doing here is I'm letting it slosh down into a little pool, and then I'm pulling that pool up the mold wall here. Now it will continue to fall down into the bottom of the mold, as you can see. And what I'll do is I'll coerce that into the center and let that pool up in the center. I do kind of want it to be a little thicker towards the outside, where it will be, where you will see all the detail. And that'll just make fiberglassing the piece a lot easier later on. And that is gel coat from Two Story Props.